Vinland Saga fans, what is up? Today, we're going to be doing the Vinland Saga openings and endings. Now, what do I have to say about the show? I've seen the show. I love the show. It's a great show. It's an adventure, absolutely. It's a tale of, I guess we can call it, perspectives on just who our main characters were. I forgot his name. Little guy. He's our main protagonist. And it just kind of takes us through the journey of how we navigate through his life at the moment, you know, post what happened to his father and whatnot. So definitely a great show in the end. And from what I heard, this is a prologue to what Vinland Saga Season 2 is going to be like. So even through after all this events, it's only a prologue. Nonetheless, I do remember opening one. I do remember opening one. It wasn't that long ago when I watched it. And then I don't really know opening two, though, and I've never seen the endings. So let's get into it. Let's do it. Vinland Saga openings and endings. Now, before the video starts, if you guys are loving what you guys are watching and you want to help your boy out with the algorithm, please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get on with the video. Let's get it. Opening one. Now, actually, before I start it, if you guys don't know, I don't really care when I do openings and stuff. I don't really care how shitty or good your show is. I review openings as like a separate entity, kind of. It's a yin and a yang between visuals and music. So that's how I critique openings and whatnot. Context of the show, maybe it's good, maybe it's bad, but how I critique openings, it's kind of on a separate plane. But let's get into it. Let's go. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at this fucking shot right now. Oh, it's so hype. Woo! Fuck, it's bloody. And the chorus. I like never expected this to be this good. The shots are so simple, but when you like kind of get a feeling of what the show is, it's like such an adventure. I love that guitar with the lightning. That is fucking cool. Ooh. This like screamo part is sick. Oh, what a good closeout shot. Holy smokes. That was opening one. That just, you know, if you love shonen style openings, if you love adventure style openings, if you just love heavy metal as it is, this is the opening for you. I love going through openings. You guys already know this by now. So I want to go through just the parts I love and the feeling you get when you listen to openings. The feeling that, you know, if I were to come into the show, I knew nothing about it, and I just listened to your opening, I'm going to be like, whoa, what's happening? Let me kind of try to get understanding of it. So let's go over what I like about the opening. So off the beginning, you know the lyrics right there when he says to sink or swim, and you know, let me put some context into it. I don't understand any Japanese at all. I'm not gonna pretend like I do, and you know, that's just how it is. But you know, in English he said to sink or swim, and then it gives us this shot of this ocean, and he said what, doggy dog world and whatnot. So it sounds like the mood set that they're trying to get us into it is when he said to sink or swim, it's like we're in the action already. We're like kind of scrambling to try to stay afloat and whatnot. And it kind of reflects on the song as well, because the song, it's not really traditional in the sense of it kind of builds you up. They play instrumentals to kind of build up that lyric, but for this one it jumps us right into it. It immediately off the bat, it's high pace immediately. It's immediately high pace. It corresponds with the lyrics and the shot here with the ocean. So I'm kind of getting a survival vibe off this track already. It feels like we're trying to cling on to life. We're trying to fend for ourselves kind of deal. That's what I'm getting from just the like 1 second of the opening. And then we get into it. oh man, like the drum roll and the guitar kind of just amping us up, reflecting with these boat rowers. It's kind of like we're like the boat rower right now, right? You know, like if this is like if I was a boat rower and I needed something to amp me up, I would play this track to amp me up. That's what it feels like right there. It kind of just reflects off of it. And I love the cut shots between him unsheathing his dagger and with the boats. I love that. That's hot. You hear that guitar? Fuck, that guitar is dangerous. And him running through the forest. See, like, it's like different stages of his life. He's running through the forest. He's living life and whatnot. And it kind of corresponds with how the singer is actually doing his music as well, right? Because when he jumps off the cliff right here, when he jumps off the cliff, you hear that drop in the background. That is perfectly timed. That is perfectly illustrated. That is gorgeous. And in the chorus, a little juked out, I'm not gonna lie. They give us a pan shot of our two supporting characters. So innocent. But this like track, when I'm really kind of looking at it, it feels like a song about survival. It feels like a song about just making it through life by yourself, right? See, look, like that shot right there. Ooh, man, look at that. He's going through. Do you see his demeanor change? He's an innocent little kid. Now he's seen the gruesome fatalities of war. It looks like he's been through battles. He's been battle tested and whatnot. So you definitely get that vibe off of this. And the screaming part, it corresponds with the slaughter of people. And this one's beautifully done. So he's kind of like, we don't really get much animation out of like the characters in the moving shot right here. But the fact that the singer is transitioning into his screamo part, let me rewind that real quick. And it makes it look like he's screaming in the shot. It makes it look like he just ran through 100 dudes. He's killed everybody. He's kind of living the horrors of war. He wants to let out all of his emotions. That corresponds beautifully with the track itself. Opening one is amazing. It's beautifully done. I love what they do and the mindset they paint to us right away. The first 1-2 seconds you listen to it, you're like, oh shit, this is a fast-paced track. It's getting us going really, really quick. It's wasting no time. I love that about it. But that's enough of that opening one. Let's get into ending one. Let's get into it. Vinland Saga ending one. Oh yeah, that's right. I've never like actually heard of this. Beautiful. Very ending-like. Ooh. Love the tone she's painting right now. Love it. What a tear-jerking story, man. Holy shit. That's good. Oh, Aimer's doing it? Oh, shit. Okay. Okay. This is amazing. Oh my gosh, this is great. I love it. Damn. I like this one. This one's actually like really well done. I thought they would stick with the very slow shots at the beginning. I thought they would stick with that for throughout the whole ending. Surprisingly not. Like when they jump us into this, when she picks up her voice, I love this fadeaway. This fadeaway is so nice because it kind of signals to us this is like something that was like a memory now. This is someone that's in our past now. And we know what it implies for us, right, as a viewer. And I love this, like, breakthrough shot. This breakthrough shot of this little boy looking out into the wild, looking out into life right there. I get a feeling he's a bit jaded right now. You see his face? A bit jaded. Kind of doesn't know, a little bit confused. That bird flying away. And then the ocean shot, rowing away. Very well done, I love it. And this one's gorgeous. This part right here is gorgeous. He's looking out into, I guess, the sunset with the stars. Beautiful harmony with the music. Beautiful harmony. And the Aurora Borealis. The sword drop. Holy. And he even has a glimpse of who he is in the future. Jeez. This one is beautifully well done. I'll chef's kiss to that. Mwah. Just an amazing ending. Something very... It's like a post-meal coffee. A post-meal coffee to kind of... A post-meal coffee or tea, the ones you have when just to kind of, you know, ease yourself into the night. I know it sounds kind of productive having coffee after a meal. Some people do it just to kind of have that after the meal. This feels like it. Doesn't feel too heavy. It's very light in terms of the lyrics. It's very light in terms of visuals. Maybe the mindset is we get off a very intense episode where something happened, and then we're just left with, like, question marks on our face. This is the track to kind of play us off because it's very soothing. It's very majestic. I love that. It's great. Ending one and opening one are definitely amazing. Let's get into opening two now. All right, let's go. Vinland Saga opening two. Never heard of this one. Ooh, gorgeous. Gorgeous. I love that, like, the bagpipes. I think that's the bagpipes. The bagpipes are sick. The painting shots are sick, and the map shots. That's creative as hell, actually. Oh, that's a cool art style, actually. Jeez, a lot to take in here. So badass, man. Holy shit. Holy shit. Damn, some brutal stuff here. Oh, is that it? Shit. Not bad at all. I think it does a pretty good job in terms of getting us into our intro shots. I love what they're doing here. Like the contrast between battle shots with the map conquering. From what it looks like here, it's a map illustrating which areas are being conquered. I love that because it kind of just goes throughout the, I guess, their world. And then right here, when it gets us into Vinland, that's pretty sick. That's fucking creative. I'm not gonna lie. I never even saw that. But I think overall, I like opening one a lot more. I don't know what it is, but I don't really see this one meshing as much. Like, the feeling I get when I listen to opening one is I feel like it's our main character, the little boy. I feel like that's his opening. Like, it's so definitive that's his opening. It feels like this is his cry for help, or maybe it's his cry for some sort of sense in the situation he's in. This one, I feel like it's a little bit more macro intensive because we do get different perspectives here. We get, I think, the prince. I forgot his name, Askeladd or something. But, you know, some cool shots here, no doubt. But I just think the harmony and the mesh between for opening one, it's just so, it works so much better. But I do love this shot though. I think I missed it. It's the wolf shot. No, did I miss it? Right here, the lone wolf shot. Like that, I think that's really cool because he feels like a loner in all this whole situation. But you know, the music's all right. The music's all right. Maybe I just wasn't, maybe opening one just set a little bit too bar high for me. But I feel like they did a lot in the visuals here, which is great. But again, when you're doing openings, it's like a storytelling, right? It's like a storytelling and it's a feeling as well. You can't really look at it so objectively for the openings. Sometimes openings, it makes you feel a certain way. And that's, you can't discount that as a feeling as well. When every time that song comes on, you're like, you just, you cling onto a memory about the show. So opening one is definitely much better. Well, I would say actually, you know, I'll walk that back. Not as much better than opening two, but I just like opening one a little bit more just of how it made me feel. And the cohesiveness between the lyrics and the shots itself. As simplistic as it was, it actually tells a very great story. And I actually understand what they're trying to communicate to me. This one feels like a more safe, generic opening. Your shots with everybody and whatnot. Hats off to them for being a little bit more creative though. But opening one stands out to me more. But that's enough of that. Let's end this off with ending two. All right, let's finish strong. Ending two, let's go. Very good shots. It's so mysterious, it's so ominous. Oh yeah, a lot of death and stuff. They even have like the crows and whatnot. Oh, Hail of Arrows. Jeez. You know what I feel like this is? It feels like Adele. Like a Japanese Adele. I don't know her, the singer's nationality. Or ethnicity or anything, but I'm just saying, like, the style. That's a compliment, but damn, this is sick. Jeez, look at these shots. Like, visually, this is just a killer already. Damn, are those angels? That was ending two. I surprisingly loved it. It's pretty good, actually. You know, with this one compared to ending one, they're actually very, I'd say they're like dead even with each other. Just the emotional feeling you get after this. Like, I love these shots because we're like, I think ending two would, I guess, be in the mid half of the season. And just for context wise, there's going to be like a lot of battles that happen. So I love this like ominous feeling, like these faceless soldiers, this kind of like, I guess pencil style kind of art with like the beats and just how she's like singing it. And just look at these shots, like post battle, the crows here to eat up like the fucking flesh, the hail of arrows. Yeah, I love the fluidity of this of these shots right now. It's very fluid. It flows so well with the music itself. It just feels like a very, it leaves you with like a, it leaves you with a kind of like a sad feeling when the show ends. It really just continues that off of like the second season. It's very well done, actually. Ending two and ending one, how they execute it in the mindset they kind of set you in, beautifully done. I 100% get behind these two endings. They're very well done. I think just the music and the OST itself is just a vibe. It's just a vibe. And that's really how openings and endings should be. It's how they carry you into your show and it's how you play you off of the show. That's really how it should be. And it's beautifully done. Well, across the board, I just feel like opening one is just a little bit more stronger than opening two in that aspect. But yeah, had a great time with this. I love these endings a lot more than I thought I would. I'm not gonna lie. Endings, you know, for me, kind of lukewarm most of the times, but I love this classic ending feeling that it kind of delivers. I really appreciate what the artists are doing here across the board. Two different takes with the ending arts. One is more pan shots, more landscape. This one, more pencil style, post-battle. Even a lot more animation out of this one, to be honest. But that's Vinland Saga openings and endings. I can't wait for season two to happen. I can't wait to just continue where we are. Protagonist left off. Overall, great show. Gotta check it out. I did openings and endings in one shot, so you guys don't have to bug me about doing the endings after. Let me know what you guys think. Again, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.